says it's Thursday, May the 3rd, and it's been another hot day. But it may sound as though Alan is moaning, but let me just tell you, especially those people in England, the temperature outside yesterday was 88 centigrade Fahrenheit. Craig is telling me Fahrenheit. In here, it was higher. So this is why Alan is probably getting a little bit agitated with the heat. But anyway, it's been, I think, as hot again. But I'm not complaining, because the sun is out and that gives me energy. And as I've said, when I leave here, I go and lie in the sun, and that's vitamin D and everything else that goes with it. But anyway, let's just look at today and where we've been. Well, if we look at where we were last night, you can see now the image of my grandson, Lewis, has taken his place in the picture. He will appear again, not under the guise as a cheeky little clown, but hopefully I will portray him as I know him. But still, I've had satisfaction in painting this, because I do believe in this particular scene, now that I've got the parrots in. I talked about synchronicity yesterday, but I'm going to mention it again, because I put the parrots in purposely because of the colours, the vibrant colours which you feel are with them. Now, it was the artist I had with me first thing this morning. Well, again, a French impressionist by the name of Paul Gauguin, who lived in the Tahiti and the other surrounding islands. And his colours and his paintings were very vibrant. And so, yes, he was with me this morning. And I continued this afternoon. If we just come up to here, we've got this young lad here who came in the winter months. That's why he's got a scarf on. But he was only about 14 or 15, and he came to show me his paintings on his mobile phone. And I did everything I can to encourage him. And he lives quite a distance away from me, and he's been twice and he hasn't seen himself on. But eventually, I've put him on. Now, I've just spoke about synchronicity. There's a synchronicity, because if you look, I'm using the predominant primary colours. The red, the green. And we've got this young lad who aspires to be an artist and is now in the canvas illustrating, probably wearing. Well, as I was just saying, there was a lot of noise around us, which is to be expected in a shopping mall. But there was a young lad who was here with his father. His father came yesterday with the same lad. The father could speak very good English. And something about the lad, he just kept looking at the painting. Now, out of all the children that I've had looking at this painting, this little boy has just stood mesmerized or transfixed, whatever one can think, but he was just taken by it. And his father couldn't get him away. And this is the second day running that he's been, and he's no older than four. So I said to his father, look, can we take a photograph of him? I'm afraid he needs to be in the picture. He's meant to be in the picture, because he can't take his eyes off it. So anyway, we took the photograph of him. And then this is where I'm coming in about synchronicity. Unconsciously, I felt, because he still stood looking after the photograph. And I thought, well, what can I give him? Well, I've got a print at the back of the canvas, but it's not for a little boy as such. But I got some photographs or photo prints of parrots, which I've been using this morning. So I gave him a copy of one, and he seemed quite pleased. But as he walked away, this is what came to me, and I call this synchronicity. Because as he walked away, I thought to myself, I've just given him a picture of a parrot. Well, if we look at this space here, I believe that space is calling out for that young lad of four. So that's where I'm going to put him. When we get the photograph done, although there's a queue to the Slovakian border still waiting to go on the canvas, I feel, and everything Alan does is about feelings, I'm going to put him exactly there. Because again, the synchronicity was attaching itself to this part of the painting. You've just heard me talk about feelings. I have led my life, basically, going on feelings. Sometimes feelings can be wrong, but sometimes you have to learn by those feelings that you give out. And everything I do and think is attached to feelings. So with this young lad, I felt he needed to be in the painting. and I then felt he needed the parrot photograph. So here we are now, he will go into the picture like that. And believe it or not, 20 minutes later, he came back again. And his dad had to wait while he stood looking at the painting. I mean, this is quite incredible for a young child of four. But what does it tell you? This painting has power. It's not only seducing young children, but it's also seducing others that look at it. I had a young lady here today who's from the pet shop, and she talks quite a while, and she can speak very good English, so it's good to be able to communicate with someone. But she said categorically, she says, there's no way you're going to finish this for July. And I stood there and I thought to myself, well, I can't argue. She seems to know more about the painting than me. I mean, I never envisaged in a space which is probably only 4 or 5 feet by less than 2 feet, and I'm accumulating nearly 30 images in such an area. I never envisaged so many young people wanting to be in this painting. Well, this is how it's materializing. But I can assure you, I believe something wondrous is happening on this canvas. Each day now, we've got loads of children who are around us, who are taking photographs. And again, I'm sure half of them would like to be on this painting. Well, there we go, that's May the 3rd. It's been a good day, and I shall look forward to tomorrow, as I always do. So if I carry that optimism, confidence, which is attached to spiritual belief, this can be nothing other than something fantastic to be beholded when it's finished. So with that overconfidence, which Alan always carries, I'm going to say good night.